father. Well, this weekend here at Croke Park, the All-Ireland hurling final will be fought between Galway and Waterford. Waterford haven't been in a final since 2008, and they last lifted the Liam McCarthy in 1959. Well, there's great excitement in the Daisha as Damien Tiernan now reports from his adopted county of Waterford.
All over Waterford, or the Daisha as it's known, thousands of people have been out painting cars, painting vans, painting sheep and donkeys, and showing their county colours. In Balnamila, local singer-songwriter John Stack has been playing the song he wrote specially for the match.
We're on the road to Croker to bring McCarthy home. Hurrah for Derek McGrath and his sidekick down the man. With his cap on face and backwards, can we win it? Yes, we can!
Ballysacard is home to the Bennett brothers. Relations and friends say the excitement is marvellous.
We have a tremendous GA club here, and we date back, actually, we contend with the oldest one here, 1885. We won our first county title.
They played an awful lot of good hurling down the years, and they were a team that was in the first four or five, like, for most of the time. So hopefully that their turn is after coming, you know.
In Lemmy Bryan and Clashmore, cars have been painted. Players, though, are remaining focused on the match.
When you're 4 and 5 pucking around your garden, you're dreaming of an All-Ireland final and playing in it. But as you said, when you're doing that dream, you win the game. You know, you don't dream of losing an All-Ireland final. So it's being there is only as good as how it goes on the day. And look, I'm not going to discredit it by saying it's all about, you know, having to win it. It's great to be there. There's only two counties there, and all the other counties would love to be there. And it's a huge honour for me and for all the lads to be in it. But we're determined now to make of it what it is, and it's so hard to get there, just to do ourselves justice on the day.
Derek McGrath has built a squad with players from 18 different clubs across the county. They're thrilled to be in the final, but keeping it low-key and resolute, they'll leave nothing behind, they hope.
The players that we have this year, like, are fantastic in Waterford, and they've a great, I suppose, mental strength, and they're very grounded and down-to-earth, and I think in a run-up to an All-Ireland final, please God, that would definitely stand to them.
Very proud now, I suppose. My own father played for Waterford in the 80s, and he's been there since day one with me training, and I suppose they're very proud of us all, and there's 8 children in my family, my mother and father too, so they've been great for me, yeah.
Patrick's family are steeped in the GAA and the Dungarvan Club. They also give great support to fundraising initiatives like golf classics organised by Club Daisha.
For all the families of all the players, it's an exciting time. It's a tense time too, but I suppose there is an element of pride attached to it, and I think people deservedly. They're a great bunch of lads. We're really proud of them all, and the honesty that they bring to their preparations and their games. And I think, in fairness to Derek and his management team, they have instilled that in the team over the last number of years, and they are fantastic ambassadors for the county, really.
Kevin Moran is a key member of the Waterford team. His father Paul helps with fundraisers and is always there for his son.
We're very proud of him. What we like about him at the end of the day is that he keeps his feet on the ground, and sure, maybe on All-Ireland Day he'll take his feet off the ground and get a few of those high balls.
I think the people are looking forward to this final, you know. The last final in 2008, you know, there was the Kilkenny hysteria was involved as well. This time it's Galway, and Galway are so far away from us really that, you know, there's no rival between Waterford and Galway as such. When you're meeting neighbours, meeting Kilkenny, Tipperary, Cork, it's a very different game. You're playing Galway, or you've beaten 10 times already in the championship, you know, even though you're outsiders, you still think you have a good chance.
Waterford local radio commentator Kieran O'Connor believes Waterford can win.
How do they beat Galway?
Panel. 20 men will win the All-Ireland this year, not 15. And we have those 20. I think that is the key to winning this, the last 15 minutes, that we have options off the bench. We have pace and we have belief.
Frank Walsh beats Paddy Buggy to score a superb point from the touchline.
1959 was the last time Waterford won the Liam McCarthy. Those who played that day still can't believe it's so long ago.
It's just incredible, 58 years, it's just incredible. And they certainly had great teams in between, and they hadn't a bit of luck.
Christine Cronin is daughter of Charlie Ware, the captain of the 1948 champions. She's come into Waterford Treasures to see a hurley, slitter and medals her family donated to the museum.
They sent telegrams mainly. There wasn't phone connections from abroad, all over different corners of the world. And I have one vivid memory of a Father Michael Ahern in Oregon. And he specifically asked that the cup be brought to his dad, who was an old man in Capoquin. He was a postman. And Daddy cycled off with the cup to show him in Capoquin, and they became lifelong friends.
A Waterford cabinet maker, with the help of local glassmakers, are making slitters made of glass. The Waterford slitter is the most popular here.
How important will this win be for Waterford if it happens?
It'll be fantastic, not just for the players themselves and GAA supporters, but the whole county, the whole city. I think, you know, the benefit, it'll put obviously a smile on people's face.
St. Mollerin's on the Tipperary border, locals show their passion for the county. Paddy Finucane has trained many teams over the years.
They've been integrating the skills, if you like, of all fellas. The guys, I mean, where would you get a man like the Brick Welsh? I mean, he's 34 years of age and look what he's contributing.
Companies and businesses all over the county have also been putting up bunting and flags, and schools such as here in Ballygunner are having exciting jersey days. The question is, can Waterford win on Sunday? People here certainly believe so.
Can we win it? Yes, we can!
And the very best of luck to the men of the Daisha.
Court now, here's Claire.
Thank you, Sharon. Good evening. It is All-Ireland Hurling Final weekend. This year's unique pairing of Waterford and Galway has certainly captured the imagination. Last night we were in the West. Tonight it's the South East. And let's hear first from our Gaelic Games correspondent Marty Morrissey on Waterford's bid to end that 58-year wait.
It's 1959 and Waterford have just won the All-Ireland Hurling title after a replay. It was only their second ever All-Ireland and they haven't won it since.
It's unbelievable. If somebody in 1959 said that, they'd be laughed at. And another statistic about it too, in all those years there was no draws. In a game like hurling with scores of 2-22 and all that, and there's only recent years there was a few draws together.
The present Waterford side have been building nicely under the guidance of this man, Derek McGrath, but he acknowledges the Daisha face a huge challenge.
The magnitude of the task is huge. There's a reason why Galway are 1-2 favourites, but look, we're there on merit, we feel, and we're looking forward to the challenge.
Waterford are well known to having their own style and system. The players are happy with it and fully focused.
It's a very simple cliche that we can control what we can control, and we're going to focus on what we can control, and that's ultimately our own performance and how we play. And, you know, that's obviously dictated by how we go to train and how we perform on the training field, and it's very simple.
Look, Galway are raging hot favourites for a reason. Super team. Michael O'Donoghue has done a super job, and you know, we have to try and get ourselves really right if we're to have any chance.
Every mode of transport will be used by Waterford fans to get to Croke Park next Sunday. There's a huge buzz, a huge anticipation, great excitement. Can Waterford bridge the gap going way back to 1959? It's Waterford against Galway in this unique All-Ireland final. It's live on the Sunday game, live on RT Radio 1. Marty Morrissey, RT News, Waterford.
So Waterford back in the final for the first time since 2008. Excitement across the county is palpable, as our South East correspondent Damien Tiernan has been finding out.
This is Jake, and we're getting ready to go for the match. And
I'm going Jake to the donkey getting his colours. Animal-friendly paint, of course, Jake, along with the sheep up at Mahon Falls.
When the break will get it, boy, he'll let the ball.
When the break will get it, oh, and the break.
All over the county, the excitement has been building. White and blue everywhere. Brenda Foley has knitted something for former Waterford player John Milan.
This is a little apron for John Milan because John said that he's going to go down the quay in Waterford in the nude. So I thought, well, while I'm celebrating, I don't want one of the best hurlers in Waterford arrested.
Lifelong fans hope this is going to be Waterford's year.
I think they're good enough, and they have the experience now, and tis their year. They'll never get a better chance.
Well, I reckon they'll do it anyway.
Yeah?
Well, I was 9 years of age the last time I saw the cup here, and I hope to see it again here.
The three Bennett brothers on the squad are from Ballysaggart. Their grandmother says if Waterford win, it'll be something really special.
What would it mean for Ballysaggart?
I did see it.
They wouldn't
go to bed until Christmas, I'd imagine.
So from Passage East to Clashmore, they're ready for Sunday. And Jake the Donkey is on the road already.
Well, let's go live to Waterford now. Damien is in Passage East. Damien, huge excitement as we've seen there, but how's the confidence in Waterford?
There is huge excitement, Claire, and yet it's somewhat grounded. We're in Passage East Hurling Club on Passaiste. Joining me now is two-time All-Star winner Owen Kelly. Owen, what's the most important thing for these players, these Waterford players, this week and obviously then building into Sunday?
I suppose just the supporters can enjoy the week, like, you know, building into the match. But I think the players really need to focus on their training, which they're doing. They train Tuesday, I think they train tonight, and then Sunday, 70 minutes is for the players behind the white lines to win the match. Like, all the build-up and that can be all done, but you have to perform on the day.
It doesn't matter about the build-up in a way, that's what you're saying?
Yeah, it don't. Like, the supporters can enjoy it, but the players, all that's in their mind is winning the All-Ireland medal on Sunday, and I think they're very focused on doing that.
Are they confident?
I'd say they are. I'd say they're very confident. They've come through good, tough matches. Kilkenny, Cork, Wexford, Offaly. The first day against Cork, OK, things didn't go their way, but they have tough matches behind them, as do Galway. So there's two confident teams in there.
Yeah, they're not overconfident, exactly. What do Waterford need to do to win on Sunday?
I think just keep going the way they're going, keep performing the way they are, stick to the game plan that's working for them with the sweeper. Just, they're flying underneath that. And just with the last 15 minutes, they're in with a shout. I think they'll bring Lee McCarthy home.
It will be an unbelievable scenes in Waterford if they do bring the Lee McCarthy home. Obviously, it'll be unbelievable in Galway as well for them. 58 years since Lee McCarthy was here in Waterford. Claire, back to you in the studio.
Thanks, Damien.
Now, with music and banter, Legends of Sport celebrate one of the most skillful games in the world and the counties competing in tomorrow's All-Ireland Senior Hurling Final. It's up for the match.
Great fans in tonight, but of course, Grania and myself will remain neutral.
We are, yeah. I love me county.
Well, we're all here and we're all
up for the match!
You're very welcome. I can't believe you're not being neutral on an important national programme. There you are in your Galway colours.
Of course I'm neutral.
How neutral are you?
I'm as neutral as this clatter ring that my mom O from Inishmeon gave me many years ago. Come on, Galway!
Well, I am neutral, but I do have a certain sympathy for Waterford. A well-known Waterford fellow saw that and said, I know it's on the other side, and sure enough, she's representing Galway. Anyway, look at who better to kick off the evening but the original Galway boy himself. He's here with a special medley of Galway Girl and the Fields of Athenry. Please give it up for Mike Denver and his band.
Well, I took a stroll and the old long walk of a day, aye. I met a little girl and we stopped to talk on a fine top day, aye. And I asked you, friend, tell me what would you do if her hair was black and her eyes were blue? And I knew right then I'd be taking a whirl around the Salthill prom of my Galway girl. We were halfway there. Waterford flat downtown on a fine top AIA. And I ask you, friend, tell me, what did you do? If her hair was black and her eyes were blue, and I knew right then I'll be taking a whirl around the sun till prom of my Galway girl. All right, let's try this one. Get a few hands up. By a lonely prison wall, I heard a young man calling. Michael, they're taking you away. Where you stole Trevelyan's corn, so the young might see the morn. Now a prison ship lies waiting in the bay. Everybody ready to sing? It's a lonely round the fields of Athen Rye. By the lonely prison wall, I heard a young man calling. Nothing matters, Mary, when you're free. Against the famine and the crown, I rebelled, they put me down. Now you must raise our child with dignity. Everybody ready to sing? Lord, I feels a fountain ride where once we watched the small free birds fly. Our love was on the wing. We had dreams and songs to sing. It's a lonely round the fields of Athen Rye.
Fantastic opening. He nearly looks like he could play himself, doesn't he? And you can catch Mike tomorrow in the Shearwater Hotel in Ballinasloe for what I'm sure he's hoping will be a night of celebration if Galway can beat Waterford. And you can check out all of Mike's dates on his website, mikedenverband.com.
Right now, he's rushing off to the Landmark Hotel, Carrick and Shannon. He's due on stage at about 11:30. You better get a move on. Watch out for Anna Duff, guard the checkpoint. Otherwise, you'll be there, Grant. You see there, Mike Denver, everybody. Well done, Mike. Thank you.
Now, it's been some journey for Galway and Waterford this year, and we're giving you...
So good. Now, there's no denying it's been some road to the final for Galway and Waterford. A lot of drama. This is how they got there.
But I hear sounds in my mind.
It's a goal for the Banner County, and it's that man, Shane O'Donnell.
Sounds in my mind.
Oh, Wexford has gone absolutely crazy, O'Brien.
It's all over. And Wexford have beaten Kilkenny.
But on the aisle.
This is a Leinster final with a difference. This is historic.
Coming face to face in a battle royale.
Here's a chance for Shanahan! Morris Shanahan! This surely is Waterford's night! And it comes out to Johnny Cohen. Cohen, Galway looking for another one. It's Cannon once again firing it in from near the sideline. It's a miracle shot! It's gone over the bar! Galway are in front!
Will Barry Kelly blow it up?
It's all over! Galway are in the All-Ireland Final of 2017!
There is an opportunity here for another goal. Austin Gleeson still! Austin Gleeson! Waterford are in the All-Ireland Hurling Final 2017!
Nice. Okay, we're going to meet three people now who are no strangers to playing on the big day.
First up, he's a Waterford legend, John Milan.
Famous hurling John. Families, Ashlyn Connolly, and winner of an All-Ireland as a player and as a manager, not you, Davy Fitzgerald. How are you?
You're welcome, Davy.
How are you?
Can I just say, John, you were in there so quick, it was like you had a horse with you.
Why wouldn't you? She's looking stunning tonight.
John, no. You know I love you dearly. When I heard that reference that if Waterford win the All-Ireland, you'd be going on a horse naked, I said, oh, John, what will it come back to you? And it's the talk of the week for you. I'd say you're getting slagged about it everywhere, are you?
Yeah, it is indeed. Look, looking back, it was back in May, I suppose, and we were actually here, and Pat Spillane, he came out with the statement that, you know, anyone outside of the top four, he'd happily ride into the winning county on the nail with the horse. And I suppose Egypt here then said, well, Jesus, you know,
I'd go home better
at Waterford. But now, it was out of elation. I said I'd happily do it. But I tell you something, Des, I have one for you. If Galway won the weekend, now I can't promise you what type of sight it will be me going down, but I tell you what would be one sight now. If Galway won the All-Ireland,
yeah,
imagine this lady riding down on a horse. I'll tell you, Des.
Yeah. I was full of confidence at the start.
I'll tell you, Des, they come from all over the way.
Gron, you could dive it. Yeah, yeah. But have you been on a horse before?
No, I haven't, no. And and I'll tell you something, Des.
Well, it doesn't help to be naked.
I'm not getting up a no pie ball pony, I'll tell you that now.
That's all right, we'll get you a lovely Connemara pony, John. Yeah. Don't wait.
If we pull it off tomorrow, the plan is Winterville is on in Waterford every December. I'm hoping to get involved in Winterville, and we're looking to raise a few bob for charity. And this team, they deserve a good holiday. They've been. We're so proud of them. This team now, they're not going to Liverpool, or they're not going to wherever they go. This team now are going somewhere exotic, and we're going to raise massive money. There's massive money gone into the team. We're have to put our hands in our pocket leading up to this final. Win, lose, or draw tomorrow, we're going to put our hands in our pocket again for this team. We're going to send them off somewhere exotic in the aftermath.
My only advice to him, Gron, you would be...
Yeah, like your only advice.
Your fair complexion, get some Vaseline as well when you're getting it, you know.
As I said, I pulled my hamstring there about six, seven weeks ago now, so I'm at the point on about a stone away, so the club championship is back, so I'm about a stone away to lose now.
Well, you lose it with stress on one day if you have to do that, I'd say.
No stress.
Of course, like your passion always came through from that famous moment that, you know, you're always linked to when you spoke about your passion that all Waterford people would know. Let's have a look.
What was it like for you watching on the sideline in a game that was just topsy-turvy?
Things were just going through my head, you know, and because, like, you know, I don't want to leave the people of Waterford down, you know, because they're my life, you know. People of Waterford are my life, you know, and I love my county, you know.
We love John Milan! Come on, John Milan!
That's a genuine passion, anyway.
No, absolutely. It's not fake. Look, I can associate myself. I have an attachment with the people of Waterford, you know, both on and off the field. But in the last couple of years, you know, we've suffered an awful lot, both city and the county. But you know what? We're starting to fight back, both on and off the field. You know, I'm very passionate about Waterford. It's a fantastic county to live in. We're a small pocket down in the southeast, but I tell you something: we are fighting back, both on and off the field. We've a bit of I'm not going to go into politics. We've a bit of investment coming in off the Arabs, about 300 million. It's going to rejuvenate Waterford City. We have the Greenway.
They give you a horse.
We have the Greenway. But I want you to come down the next, say, November, December, downtime. Want to get you down the Greenway. We'll put you up. We'll get you a big steak dinner in probably the Campbell Hotel.
Every man has his fries, Desi's steak.
We're fighting on and off the field.
Nice. Well, I'd love to go because Ray Darcy keeps singing its praises.
But I'm going to hold you to that now.
Yeah, okay. I'll be there. Look forward to it.
John's passion is clear. I think we can all agree. Yeah. But Ashlyn, you weren't even born when your Uncle Joe gave one of the most famous speeches in GAA history.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't remember the first time I saw it, but every time I do see it, it gives you goosebumps.
It does.
Just because it, I guess it's so raw and so authentic, and it was Ascuelga. And then you had like Joe McDonagh sing a song. Like, who does that? Mm. And you know what, in Croke Park when they win. And then it was very true because like there was people all over the world. Like there is right now, and there's Glinda and their Cree, you know, for the game tomorrow. So yeah, it is a brilliant speech.
Mm. We're going to take a small reminder, just a small clip of it now.
Hep hep! Hep hep! Hep hep! People of Galway, we love you!
People of Galway, we love you! He heard it somewhere before.
For young people, it was the Pope had visited Galway and said it. That's where it came from. Yeah. But look, you then followed on and you played with the county and had great success with the Camogie. Were you always going to be a Camogie player in that family?
No, like I went playing when I was 7, and I didn't like it at all. And I and I left. And I know you have a 7-year-old. And then I went back up when I was 10, and I loved it.
You like about it at 7?
I don't know. I just said I wasn't going back. I just didn't like it. But then when I went up when I was 10, I don't even remember asking to go up. I think Mam and Dad just sent me up. Mm. And I loved it, and I took to it. And the best thing for me about Camogie and why I'm so passionate about women in sport is because it stands to you in your life off the field, and it teaches you discipline, and it teaches you, you know, confidence, and it teaches you teamwork and collaboration and how to hold yourself and carry yourself. And I do really feel like I have a few nieces, and I'd love for them to play sport because it really stands them in later life, even in their careers. And if I wasn't playing Camogie, I wouldn't have had the opportunity to be here tonight. So
I'm sure Auntie Aisling will organise that for the nieces, the way the passion is there as well.
The passion is there, and the passion is there. Davey, though.
Oh, Davey. Davey is so passionate, he makes the news.
Thanks.
An awful lot of the fans, I think, would have...
Apparently frustrated at the referee's decision not to award his side a free, 17 minutes into Wexford's defeat to Tipperary, Fitzgerald then became involved in a confrontation with two Tipperary players.
Davey Fitzgerald has come on. Well, he's absolutely incensed.
He's the most passionate, but I personally, I love his passion for the game, but that's my own.
You are very passionate. Look at that face. You'd think butter wouldn't melt in his mouth.
That was a great clip you picked. No. I played for 18 years. You might have found something else.
It's true. But you are very passionate, aren't you?
Listen, on that particular day, I think Tip had scored 2 goals, and when Tip get in a roll and you give it another 10 minutes, and if you're in that form, you could find yourself another 3 or 4 down. And I remember my sister saying to me afterwards, why did you pause when you went out? You're out about 10 yards. And I said, I know I'm in big trouble here. But there was no turning back. Okay, it broke up the game, which was probably my thing, but did I deserve the 2 months? 100% I did say. Listen, I have no regrets. Them things happen, so they do. We didn't kill anyone. The only regret I had is that...
Not for the one to try.
The only regret I had is that Jason Ford got suspended. I was disappointed in that because, in fairness, it was nothing, you know?
Yeah. But you had a very good summer, though, at Wexford. You couldn't have gotten done better, virtually.
One of the most enjoyable summers I've had, and I've had a good lot of them. I've been so privileged with playing with Clare, managing Waterford, managing Clare. But this summer with Wexford was absolutely phenomenal. The lads gave me everything, and I have to say the supporters are absolutely incredible. Like we got promoted, got to Leinster final, and I thought we did really well, so we did this year, and I think there's better things ahead for them.
And of course you had a great summer with Waterford that we all know about.
Yeah,
you did. Yeah. You got to an All-Ireland final.
Listen, I loved my time. Imagine having to train your man.
In fairness.
And there was a lot more than him there too. But you know what? It was incredible. Like I went in 2008, and I'd say they only brought me in for a month or two to fill a gap at the time, but I ended up there for 3.5 years. I think we got four semi-finals, three Munster finals, and an All-Ireland final. It was fantastic. They're very passionate down there, and I'll tell you, write them off at your peril tomorrow. They're going to be there or thereabouts tomorrow. Oh, yeah.
The De La Salle man has great hope tomorrow, haven't you?
Yeah,
the club, for, speak for your club.
Yeah, it's a massive day for our club. Seven lads involved.
Wow.
You know, Kevin is captain, Derek is manager, Fergal O'Brien is the fitness coach, and then we've Mark Cooney is the goalkeeping coach, and then we've the other three players. It's set to have seven lads involved. It's, I mean, the atmosphere down in De La Salle the last couple of weeks is really after building, and we're so proud of them.
You played with Derek as well.
Played with Derek, what an incredible man. And, you know, he's done so much for De La Salle, both at club level and at a college level. They've had Harty's success and All-Ireland success. My fondest moment, Derek McGrath, he played in the 2005 county final, but we were chasing our first county final in 2008. He was absolutely flying it at number 11. And we were out in Pilltown under lights training the Tuesday night before the county final against Abbeyside, and he pulled his hamstring. And he broke down that night, I'll never forget it, broke down, started bawling, crying, and then he broke down myself, the whole team, you know, nearly broke down, and we said, we're going to do it for Derek McGrath. But, you know, he was the bigger man, you know, it wasn't about himself, it was about the team. He re-galvanised himself. What a man in the dressing room, an incredible man in the dressing room. Not being biased, because I have a family connection or a De La Salle connection, yeah, but he's just an incredible manager and an incredible man for De La Salle.
Well, that's good. Well said. There's a more of a connection here because when John talks about it, this is John's sister, Sarah, who's married to Derek, and we wish you best of luck tomorrow. It's a nerve-wracking few days. And beside me here is the family of Kevin Moran's family. This is Kevin's mum, Marie, Kevin's dad, Paul, and his fiancée, Aoife. You're very welcome, all of you, and lots of other members from the Waterford camp. Paul, as Mam says, you can do the talking for the family. To have your young fella leading the team out tomorrow must be so special for you. Probably so nervous for him, are you?
Yeah, but, you know, he's quite capable on the day. We have a lot of faith in him. Very proud day. We never thought this kind of thing would happen. Coming from Galway, ending up in Waterford. Yeah.
I wanted to come to that. You were a Galway man, providing a rock to Waterford like that. Did you do great for the county? He did, but he's a great lad. Do you get nervous at the games? You seem cool, man.
Somewhat. Yeah. Somewhat, yeah. But he's in control usually.
Oh, he's in control, yeah. But for you, will you send him a message tomorrow now, or will you leave him off?
No, I'll leave him off.
Will you?
Yeah.
And if they win, would you be calm in the crowd, or would you be excited? You
know,
do you get excitable?
I'll probably go in with John into jail.
Marie, best of luck to you all. Aoife, best of luck. It's fantastic. So I'll tell you, it means an awful lot, obviously, to all of these families from Waterford. And in Galway, it's fever pitch right now. Have a look at this.
A storm has been brewing over Galway Bay for the past 12 months. Storm Galway has been picking up speed and gathering momentum as it moves across the country. It's due to hit the east coast tomorrow, roaring into Croke Park in what is widely forecast to be a lightning finish.
A tide nor waters wide could wean my heart away. Forever true, it flies to you, my own dear Galway Bay.
Waterford is for the chap.
This is Portumna GAA Club.
in East County Galway on the banks of the Shannon.
This is where Joe Canning plays.
Canning?
Joe. Who?
I've been hurling with him in the local team here for 20 years. Hurling is Joe Canning, and Joe Canning is hurling because it could be a league game, a championship game. He'll score under the stand or he'll just pull something ridiculous off.
It's a miracle shot! It's gone over the bar!
He's just a special, special talent. We're all so proud of him here in Port Humna.
Even the dogs in the street
know that Galway's going to bring home the cup.
Storm Galway is making a very necessary journey. Resistance is futile. I repeat, resistance is futile.
Resistance is futile with Teresa.
Yeah, I actually agree. Aisling, all joking aside, Galway people have often trudged home on this Sunday in September with one hand as long as the other. Yeah. It's happened many times.
Yeah.
This
yeah.
is our time, isn't it?
Yeah, I definitely think and I'm confident. No, tomorrow, you'll have to wait another year.
No, the weight of 59 of them.
What's one more? No, I definitely think like Noel Larkin and Micheál Dunne, who have brought something special to Galway. They're a more mature, a more balanced, a more consistent team. And I think we've solidified a few positions like full-back and centre-back. Mm-hmm. We're less reliant on Joe Canning, as we have been in the last couple of years. Conor Cooney's having a great year. Conor Whelan's having a great year. Jonathan Glynnin tomorrow will add a dynamic.
Nothing can go wrong.
No one knows how that's going to work out. So, yeah, I think tomorrow is going to be our day for those reasons.
And, Davey, you're saying Waterford are right in it. They played a sweeper system. You have played it. And I find it strange. Do you get frustrated by the criticism of the sweeper system?
Yeah. It's been pretty out there for the last few years, you know, and I look at even Derek at times and the criticism he's taken below there, and it baffles me. Like, he was in two Munster finals. He's in All-Ireland. He's been in three semi-finals. He's kept Waterford to the forefront. And he obviously does it for a reason. When you talk about a sweeper, if you really look at every team and analyse it, I can guarantee you there's teams out there, the minute the ball goes over their half-back line, the three half-backs have gone back, their midfielders have gone back, their half-forward line has gone back in close to their half-back line. You've actually more defenders at times with the way they play. See, you do. Whereas if you play like Derek plays at times, you have the one guy back there, he's minding 2, 3, 4. That means 5, 6 and 7 don't have to go back as far. I just think it's blown out of proportion. Maybe people don't understand it. So I do. But I admire the likes of Derek, who has stuck to his guns. Like, he came out in the Munster Championship against Waterford. He didn't. He went 15 and 15. And I remember being at the game, and I said, like, why are you changing? And he went back and he did the right thing. And I'm glad he did, because that suits that particular team. Does it suit every team? No. Like, Galway 100% are great the way they play. And I have to say it as well, like, Micheál got a lot of stick last year and he's done an incredible job. And there's a lot of steel, trust me, with Micheál Donoghue as well. They play to what suits their teams, and tomorrow is going to be great. I see two things. One, I don't think Waterford can go from the sharp ball. They have to play more sharp ball. If you start to hit it long on top of Galway, I think Galway will win it. And so it's going to be, can Waterford stay playing short, and how will Galway react to that? But it's going to be a cracker. I personally can't wait to go out tomorrow and enjoy this game as a neutral. It's going to be fantastic. And what an atmosphere I expect there.
Indeed. And John, quickly, why will Waterford win it?
I think, you know, after we defeated Kilkenny up in Torres, what a joyful and emotional moment that was, you know, to come out of Torres that night. I think we have momentum going with us, and we followed on with that win against Wexford. And I just think that after kicking on, I think there's a belief there. I went down to the Granville Hotel to see him off today. They've no fear, and I think we'll do the business tomorrow. But just before I go, Des, I just want to tell you one story. There's a man, and I have to tell this story, and it upsets me that Conor Gleeson is missing the final tomorrow. Back 14 years ago, I was sent off in an All-Ireland semi-final. and I missed the All-Ireland semi-final, and a phone call came in, and, you know, Conor and Fergie's mum and dad are up at Mary and them, and Jimmy are up in the audience there. A phone call came in that, you know, that Conor was had to go on through, that he needed a phone call to give him a bit of a lift up. And they asked me would I say a few words. Conor was only 8 at the time. And, you know, it was a very difficult phone call to make. And I remember coming off the phone that day and saying to myself, he was 8 years of age, and I remember saying to myself, this lad is going to turn into an unbelievable chap. You know, and here we are, you know, 14 years later. Conor Gleeson, we're not going to forget him tomorrow. He was unbelievable. He's all-star form, you know, hurler of the year form. He won't be forgotten tomorrow. It upsets me he's missing the final. But mm-hmm. I'll tell you something. Tony Keady will be looking down in Galway tomorrow. But one sure thing, Shane Gleeson, Conor's brother, will be looking down at Waterford tomorrow.
I'm delighted you mentioned, because that was on my mind. For any fella to miss the final like that is dreadful. Listen, thank you very much. Absolutely. Have a great day tomorrow. You're all looking forward to Ashton. Thank you so much. It's been lovely to have you here.
Really have.
All right, now, Bord Gáis Energy is the official energy partner of the GAA and proud sponsor of the Senior and Under-21 Hurling Championships. Now, they want to help you control your home heating and hot water on the go. You do it via your smartphone, tablet or laptop this winter. And that's why they've given a Hive Active heating system with installation by a Bord Gáis Energy engineer to every member of the audience. You'll save a fortune on your bill. It'll keep the losers warm in the winter. Anyway, after the semi-finals, we launched a competition to find the biggest hurling fans from both Galway and Waterford.
We had an almighty response from the fans, the length and the breadth of both counties. Unfortunately, not everybody can win, so here's a flavour of just some of the brilliant entries we got in.
Baby, there's nothing holding me back.
My mom, she's crazy about Galway. She's so crazy, she has different maroon and white outfits to fit the occasion.
They said they'd rather go, but no, we won't, no. Aussie, put your helmet on, we're going to Broker.
When Galway lift the Lee McCarthy, you'll see Frank Ryan, the maddest Galway supporter out there.
Rick Welch, Colin Dunford, Derek McGrath, boy, go on, Derek.
So now you have to be shouting for Galway today, okay?
As we jog on Cork up in Crow Park, which monster team would find the spark?
What's a girl to do to get her hands on an All-Ireland ticket or two?
Hunt the tribesman!
Up to Yasha!
Come on, the first cock hole!
Up Waterford!
Would you love to give them all a ticket? After the break, we'll meet the winners here in the studio. You won't want to miss it. See you in a few minutes.
You're very welcome back. Now, we had a huge response to our biggest fan competition, as we were saying before the break. And now we have our Galway winner with us, Julie Camartin. Julie, co-hortachas. Tell us why you're Galway's biggest fan.
I suppose, Grania,